Hello guys, Sonic Love here. As you can imagine, I'm quite proud of this one really, because I got some custom made buttons for it. Predominantly the white, orange and yellow version. All seem to have black buttons or corresponding colours to match. But I got some luminous orange. I thought it was a nice change, matching right the way around, which is always good, even on the side. So this is just going to be an overview really of the Retroid Pocket, not so much a review. Obviously the likes of ETA Prime, Techie, these guys, the spec buffs and know their stuff. So yeah, it's just going to be an overview. So it'll just be going through stock firmware. Obviously this is the dual boot version of the Android 6 and also the app store itself, with the ROMs attached. So let's get this thing booted up and started, shall we? So as you guys probably know already, I've done a few videos on the 350M. So if you haven't seen those videos, please go check it out. Damn, that was loud. This is the Android base system that's booted in. We don't want that. I'll try and get my angles better today. Apologies for that. So as you can see, we have all the listings, all categories recent. If we scroll to the top and go to categories and come back down, if we press left or right, you then have the choice of going for each separate emulation. MAME, FBA, Dreamcast, and so forth. You get the picture. I think we'll start off with a bit of Mario Kart, I think. Here we have the original. This was more third party. Wasn't very good, to be honest. Shouldn't have been released. Released way too early. It was like a pre-production model that got interest from third parties, and third parties then started the seller. Hence why the name was changed to the Retroid Pocket, because it got so demoralized and people didn't really see it as a good brand, hence the name Retroid Pocket. So now, as you can see, emulation is a lot better all round, which is good news. Welcome to
Good start. So emulation-wise, it runs a lot better than the previous model. A lot more easy, as the analog stick itself is actually not digital anymore. It is an actual true analog, which makes a huge difference, especially for games like Super Mario. It makes a massive difference. Simply clicking that. Really responsive now. There was problems with glitchy graphics on the first original, which was off-putting really. It really stuttered as well, but this seems to be running at a constant 30 frames per second. And no graphical glitches. But the tiles in this room used to flicker. It was really ugly.
Yeah. Come on.
So as an overview, I think it's really, really positive. I think the improvements that they made overall, obviously better screen, tempered glass, analog stick, the dual boot, finally be able to add your own ROMs. If you have any prior experience with Android 6 and the emulation side to that, then I think that you'll be very, very pleased with what you can do on that side. Pick up and play. If you just want to obviously download the APK file, you can go straight into what I've been showing you now, which is the retro system itself with the obviously very naughty store, the arcade section where you can download ROMs. So overall, for the price, I think that it's really good. I'm very impressed. Runs, I'd say, at least 25% better than the previous model. All the emulators seem to be very well optimized. Overall, yeah, I think it's, you wouldn't be disappointed if you bought it. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe.
Tune in for the channel for a lot more different types of emulation on different platforms. I will be doing next a few more tests on the 350M. Maybe go through a few more emulation on here if I get a lot of comments saying that they wish to see more of the Retroid Pocket and different aspects of it. I also have the LCL Game Boy to review as well, do an overview, and also the CM3. And I just upgraded the CM3 in another device, which I'm looking forward to showing people as well, because it makes a massive difference. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Give me a like if you feel you need to. If not, then hit the dislike button. As I say, see you on the next one.